I'm Bob McDonald, and welcome to Blethering with Bob on shmuTV, where the guests and I blether, and hopefully you're entertained. On the show today, we have Scott and Sarah. Our first guest today is Sarah. Sarah, welcome to the show.
Thank you. I'm really pleased to be here. Thanks for inviting me, Bob.
Thanks. So, for those who don't know, what do you do?
Okay. Well, I've got two jobs in Aberdeen within the creative industries. I work at Aberdeen College as a lecturer where I teach TV production, and I also manage shmuTV, so I work at Station House helping promote and develop their video projects.
Okay. So how did you get to do what you are doing?
Well, I started off doing motion graphics. Probably I've worked for about 10 years. Started off doing motion graphics in London, and I was commissioned twice by Channel 4. And then I decided I wanted to come back to Aberdeen. I'd been away from Aberdeen about 12 years, so I decided to come back home. Okay. And yeah, it was just through a coincidence that I started working at Station House. So I worked there for about 3 years developing the video projects and working with the young people.
Okay, so how did you come to work in Channel 4?
Well, the first commission that I had was actually a competition. And there's, I would say for young people that are watching this programme, if they're interested in how to get into television, there are a lot of short film competitions and, like, you know, short advert competitions and things. So I entered a competition to create a little ident for Channel 4, submitted my idea, and they really liked it, and then it got commissioned. So from there I kind of had an in, as it were, and I met a couple of producers, and my ident was made. It was shown after the Channel 4 news, which was quite exciting. So that was my first piece of work, and then I also did a short film, which, I mean, yeah, I don't particularly like, but anyway.
That's great. It must be really rewarding to finally see the finished product and watching it on the television.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. I mean, there's a lot. I think what it showed me was there's so much hard work goes on behind the scenes. I mean, from the initial idea, which is kind of like a treatment, and then from the script and all of the people involved and the producers, and I mean, that's why there's so many names on a kind of list of credits. It's amazing how many people are involved in helping a production. Even something like this today, shmuTV, there's a lot of people behind the scenes and involved in kind of making everything happen.
So how does your experience with Channel 4 translate over to helping us here at shmuTV?
Well, I think what I had access to at Channel 4 was I had a couple of industry mentors that really gave me a lot of support and guidance and gave me advice on how to film things and, you know, how to create effects and things that I wanted to do, and they really helped me bring my idea to life. So I suppose when I'm working with young people and when I'm teaching or when I'm at SHMU, I'm kind of supporting people and helping bring their ideas together. So it's kind of mentoring, and I think, yeah, that's what I got from that experience. It kind of gave me guidance on how to help other people take their ideas and develop them into films.
So what's your favourite part? And part of working with television?
I think I love creating images. So whether they're, because my background's actually fine art, so whether I'm creating a still image or taking a photograph, I absolutely love composing something. So when I'm filming with a camera, I really like thinking about the position of where things are, the colours, and how it all comes together. So I really enjoy that.
Okay. So finally, what advice would you give to somebody who wanted to work within television?
Okay, I would say, I mean, it's hard, it's really competitive, but I would say there's some amazing training courses. I would say there's also, I mean, for people in Aberdeen, for young people.
This is absolutely excellent, because we learned how to edit, present. We even got to try hands at graffiti work to do the backdrop for, which isn't currently here.
But it will be for the next show.
That's what we're hoping.
Yeah. But, I mean, there's lots of opportunities in Aberdeen, and especially at Station House, to come and make films, be involved. But I think for young people, definitely when I was young, there wasn't mobile phones that you could edit on. There wasn't, you know, computers. Well, there was computers, ZX Spectrums, but you couldn't do much with them. But now you've got all that technology where you can be making phones on your, you know, your computer, your iTouch. So I think the technology is there where young people can be making, you know, programs and editing them, uploading them, sharing them on YouTube. I mean, even what we're doing today, you know, you can be broadcasting.
A lot of the VTs that we've been working on were actually made on Movie Maker, which is free and on most computers.
Yeah, yeah. And I mean, obviously at Station House we teach on Avid, and at college we use Avid, but really that's a great package. It's free and I did use it myself before we started doing this course, just to see what kind of things you could do, and it really is quite easy to use. Mm-hmm. Film things on your phone, upload them, edit them.
YouTube is quite similar. It has its own built-in editing suite.
Okay.
So you can just upload your videos to YouTube and edit them there.
Yeah. So do you have your own YouTube channel?
I do, but I don't use it as much as I'd like to.
I think today for this show afterwards, it's obviously live on Ustream, but I think we're going to put it on YouTube as well, aren't we?
Yep.
Yeah.
And that's youtube.com/shmuTV.
Yep.
Thank you very much for talking to me today. I'll be back after these messages, where I'll be talking to Scott Ironside. So don't go away.
Oh look, there's a... Oh no, she's fallen over. Oh, what? Is that a girl? Is that a cat kit? Oh, she's taking the cat kit. Ah, take a break. Take a cat kit.
Welcome back, and now we're talking to Scott Ironside. Hello, Scott.
Hello, Bob.
So, Scott, can you tell us who you are and what you do?
Hey, well, my name's Scott Ironside. I'm a trained actor, director, and I'm a lecturer here at the shmuTV.
Excellent. So, I also hear that you've done some stand-up work. Do you think that helps here at shmuTV?
I suppose it does, yeah, be able to have a laugh and so things aren't too serious when we're working.
It does definitely keep the spirits up.
Yeah, I think so.
And it's quite a lively bunch here.
Definitely, I would definitely say that you're a lively bunch, absolutely.
So, what's your favourite part of working here at shmuTV?
Going home and getting away from you. Because you're horrible people. No, I'm just joking.
We're horrible, but we're lively.
My favourite part of working at shmuTV, it's just like passing on my knowledge and watching you guys develop your ideas into TV shows that we can broadcast live today.
So what made you want to work within shmuTV?
It was a good opportunity for me to pass on some of the skills that I've been taught by other sort of industry professionals.
Okay.
I've received training from people that have worked at Channel 4, people that have worked at the BBC, folk that have worked at ITV, and it's been an invaluable experience for me, like being an actor and then like going behind the camera, learning what goes on to make a film or make a TV programme, and to be able to pass that knowledge on to you guys and see the next generation of TV producers and filmmakers, it's exciting. It's exciting for me.
Okay. So what would you say your highlight of the week working with us here at shmuTV would be?
The banana muffins.
They have been really nice, especially when mixed up with chocolate.
Oh, the chocolate banana muffins that we got at break times were fantastic.
Thanks, Susie.
The other highlight, again, is just seeing the programmes coalesce from an idea into an actual physical programme. That's brilliant to see. And it's brilliant to see you guys having so much fun making them as well.
So what's your favourite part of seeing the finished product?
Just watching it. Just actually sitting back, like thinking about the work that you've done, seeing the nice camera shots and going, oh, they did well there, or that's a nice piece of music, or that's a really good line. And
it is nice to see something that you've done well and think, I did that well. Yeah. Well done, me.
Yeah, yeah. No, I mean, it's really, really good just to sit back and watch the hard work pay off. That's really good.
Okay. So what would you say to anybody who wishes to work within television?
Get a real job. Go and work in the post office or something. No, I'm just joking.
We all know what they say about people in the post office.
I don't. if you're really keen to get into TV, if you've got script ideas, a TV program idea, write it down. Start writing scripts, start filming little bits. As Sarah was saying earlier, the technology nowadays is moving so fast that everybody can become a filmmaker. You got it on your camera, on your phone, little handy cams and stuff, you've got laptops and things like this. Yep. You can just start filming things, start filming your ideas, see if you can get a wee bit of training as well, and just be enthusiastic, be ready to get up at 5 and if the other guys are going to get up at 6 and you'll be on the next set of the next big blockbuster in no time.
So basically spend your life shattered.
You do give up a little bit of sleep, but what you get back is ultimately much more rewarding.
So how late would you say the latest shoot you've ever had to do would be?
I was doing in London a few months ago and I did a 14-hour shoot.
Okay.
That was pretty long. That
so
was pretty
what was that
long.
For?
That was for a film called The Lost Boy.
Okay.
It was a Peter Pan reinvention, and I was Captain Hook.
I can see that.
Yeah, can you? I'm not typecast at all. It's fine.
The crazy person with the hook.
Yeah.
So imaginable.
14 hours is probably the longest shoot I've had to do so far.
So I suppose that must have been rewarding in the end.
When you see the finished product, mm-hmm. yeah, but at the time, no, because you want to sleep.
So, was it a good laugh working with people?
Great, great laugh, yeah, because they were all trained professionals, they were nice and chilled out, relaxed, happy people. There was a lot of fun in the background, as we were saying earlier on, a bit mm-hmm. of joking, which keeps the spirits up.
Yeah.
Especially on a big, long day like that, you really need to have a good laugh with your crew.
Okay. Well, thanks for talking to me today, Scott. Thank you very much to my guests, Scott and Sarah, and thanks to you at home for tuning in. Goodbye.
Showing it.
Yeah, by shouting in my face, insulting me every 5 minutes.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
God, you're being so childish. Amber, just grow up.
You grow up. You're the one that's always insulting me. I didn't even do anything to you.
Just grow up here and get on with it, Amber. You treat me like crap as well.
I don't treat you like crap. You treat me like crap.
Oh my God, you know what? Just leave me alone. Shut up! You need to grow up and gag a bit!
I didn't come here to listen to you moan and shut up for 5 minutes, will you?
Will you both just stop it? You're both as bad as each other. I'm sick of being stuck in the middle of this. Just grow up!
Ailsa, don't do it! I need you!
I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna jump! I can't take it anymore!
I can help you through this. Come on, just come down. We can talk about this.
I've got to do it.
Ailsa, I need you. You can't leave me. You're my everything.
To see her break her heart, we go back to the start. Love, hate, Ailsa Kane.
Coming soon to shmuTV.
Hello and welcome to Melissa's Music Review with me, Melissa. Joining me today, we have Liam.
Hello.
Hello, Liam. How are you doing today?
I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah.
So today we will be talking about new songs in the chart this week and our reviews on them. So now we're going to talk about Justin Bieber's new song, Beauty and a Beat.
On my incline, world tour, it's mine. 10 little letters in a
Justin Bieber and Nicki Minaj there with Beauty and a Beat. Oh, Liam. Just makes my heart sink. It's a brilliant song.
I don't like it.
No? Well, why?
It's okay.
Liam,
it's not
tell
his
me.
Best song.
What's his best song, Liam?
Doesn't really have any good songs.
Liam, just get off my stage. Just gobsmacked. I can't believe you've just said that.
Why?
Because I think he is brilliant. He has the looks, he has the voice, he can dance. I'm getting lots of funny looks now. I just think he's got everything. And he, like, compared to what he, like, in 2009, he was very short and high-pitched. And now he is bigger and more
vocal.
Yeah.
He has a deeper voice, is
yes,
that what you're
that's
saying?
That's what I'm saying, Liam.
Okay.
And Nicki Minaj, what do you think about Nicki?
She seems a bit too fake. She's very...
Yeah, I'll agree with you on that one. Yeah. Do you have any favourite songs of Nicki Minaj?
No.
No? Well, it's worth a try. So, the most popular song in the chart this week is Psy with Gangnam Style. Here's the video.
Open Gangnam Style! Gangnam Style! Op, 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 op. Open Gangnam Style! Gangnam Style! Op, 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 op. Open Gangnam Style! Hey, sexy lady!
Liam, stop. We're back on. Getting carried away. So that was Psy with his new song, Gangnam Style. Another song in the chart this week. Also, the popular song in the chart this week.
Yeah.
Are you a fan?
I love it. It's awesome. It's amazing.
Can you show me your dance moves again, Liam?
Yep, that's it.
A few dance lessons needed. Well, I don't know about it. It's getting a bit old, but it's very catchy.
I think it's too mainstream now. Everybody knows about it.
He needs a new song out, then have humour, dance moves, definitely. So the last song we'd like to review is One More Night by Maroon 5, another song in the chart this week.
So I cross my heart and I hope to die, that I'll only stay with you one more night.
Having a wee boogie.
I was, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was.
That was Maroon 5 with their new song, One More Night. Are you a fan? Are you not a fan?
I really like Maroon 5.
Yeah, I think they're really good as well. In Payphone.
I like this song better than Payphone.
See, so I don't know, close second.
Yeah.
Brilliant song.
But it's a really good song.
Like. So, what do you like about the song?
Everything.
Everything.
I find it a bit weird that he's boxing in the video though.
Well, that's what I'm confused about as well. So that's why it's a close second, because Payphone's got exploding cars going about and everything.
And that's just amazing, so boom.
Yeah. And then robbing banks and the whole shebang's there. Just everything. So have you ever seen Maroon 5 in concert?
No, but I wish I could, because I think it'd be really cool live.
Yeah, top on my wish list. Oh, we'll go together.
Okay.
Yeah. It's an idea. So sadly, it's coming to an end of today's show, but come back next week because we'll have another great show with great tunes and some great chat. See you then.
Bye.